congratulations on the movie. The re-teaming with Magic Mike, Steven Soderbergh. Were you relieved to get to keep your kit on this time?
More than I could possibly ever try to explain to you. There's always a moment in those movies where like you're about to have to take everything off, and you're like, why did I write this like that? Like, what? I've done this to myself. This was so stupid. And I didn't have any of that this time. I made sure that was remedied.
Pants on all the time.
Pants on all the time, shirt on all the time, and I get to eat whatever I want to eat.
93% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Yeah.
Certified fresh, critically acclaimed. Movies like that usually you think have a certain type of tension while you're filming them, but this looked like quite a lot of fun to do. Even with Daniel Craig there, he's an intimidating guy, but he looks like he's having a blast.
Yeah, I think, I mean, on a Soderbergh film, Greg, he has this longtime producer. It's always sort of a relaxed set. I mean, even during very, very heavy scenes, I mean, I think in life, things aren't, you're not going, oh God, this is going to be so heavy. Like, you're trying to, like, just cover it and be like, oh, everything's fine. But they have so much fun in what they do. Like, it's a really enjoyable process to get to make a movie, even though, like, it is hard work, it's long hours, and you have to make a lot of decisions and try to make them as succinctly and economically as possible. But when you have as many talented people that's on this movie, you, like, Steven sort of sets it up that way, that you can just turn on the cameras and let it rip.
Speaking of Danny Boy, actually, you're in the next Kingsman movie, so
yeah,
you work with two of the United Kingdom's greatest spies. In Taron and Dan, who would you prefer to
oh, come on,
with?
that's impossible to answer, but I mean, I guess since I'm not in any of the Bond movies, Taron's my man.
Like
I'm loyal, like, come on.
And in the movie, obviously, it's Logan Lucky, you're supposed to be unlucky guys. In life, I mean, do you have any sort of lucky charms or superstitions that you do when you're getting onto a movie set, you're going to an event like this? Lucky underwear.
A lucky number. I mean, I just have a lucky number in life. It's not something I do on a movie or not. Just 33. 33 is my lucky number. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You have nothing like embroidered 33 or anything like that?
It's on my bike, my motorbike. Yeah.
That's probably the best thing to have a lucky number on.
Yeah, exactly. You're just like, please don't lay this thing down. But that's really it. Like, I see it. Sometimes I see it around when something good's happening. So I don't know. It's this weird little superstition.